Hello everyone, a very good afternoon. This is Amit from ITI Kerang. And it's Sunday afternoon and really great to see such a great participation. And we have around 500 plus applications who have registered for this workshop. And so due to the limitation of Zoom, you know, along with the Zoom, we have also been streaming it on YouTube. So by chance, if it gets lag or something, the YouTube is the best platform to, you know, learn the workshop of video editing. Before we invite our guest speaker, the trainer for today for the video. So in ITI Kerang, we have started doing this academy stuff wherein, you know, we're trying to bring people who have some skills and people who want to learn something. So it's more of a buddy system wherein we're trying to build up a community to you know, help each other to learn different stuffs. So it's a first this webinar workshop of video, and we hope you like it. And we are going to continue this for a couple of different areas. And I hope you learn, and we also be circulating a feedback form after the session. So please do fill it, so you know, we'll have a feedback about the session and what an improvement we have to do it. We invite Lohit. Lohit, over to you.
Yes, Amit, thank you so much. And We have a few more people to come, so we'll just wait for a few minutes before we completely start. But yeah, till then, first of all, thank you so much to everybody that are watching this right now, attending this right now. Honestly, when we started this, our target was like 50 to 100 people or something, but now we got like 500 registrations, and yeah, hopefully more people will be coming. Yeah, they are adding on, so that's okay. I didn't know how to react to that, and first of all, yeah, thank you so much for joining this, and happy Friendship Day to all of you guys. This is such a great day, you know, to be doing this, and so yeah, as you can see, there are so many people that will be joining this session, so that's the reason everybody is put on mute. But if you have any questions, you can put it on the chat or even on the YouTube, you can, and so that we'll be able to sign out. Okay, just give me a minute. I think more people are joining right now. Okay, so this is, yeah, thank you, happy Friendship Day, but please don't spam this so much, because as you can see, there are so many people, hence the questions that will be asked will be missed out. So yeah, this is our first workshop that we are doing from Iti Kerang, and for me especially, this is the first time I'm doing with so many people. So I am honestly excited, pumped up, but yeah, in case if anything, any issue comes up, we'll soon try to resolve it. So please don't worry about that. And if from your side personally, if there is any network issue or such, please make sure it's sorted. And in case if this lacks, you can switch to YouTube also, which has been provided in the group, so that you don't have, in case if you don't, you know, somewhere if there's a network issue or something, don't worry, this video will be recorded, so that you will be able to get it even after the session, so don't worry about that. And okay,
we should start. I think all have joined now.
Yeah, people are joining both the links, so yeah, that's okay. Great. Yeah, Amit, can you provide the YouTube link? Okay, fine.
Yeah.
So fine. So for most of you guys, like even I thought, okay, we'll just start the session and let other people join, and video editing, you know, many of you might think that video editing is just taking a few clips and then trimming them and then mixing up them to make an edition of 10 or 20 video clips, but video editing is just more than that, because even I think a few years before even I thought video editing was the same thing. But the more I got to learn, I learned that video editing is more than just a trimming of clips, and it has so much more which can't be explained in just one sentence. So I was really confused when I saw the Premiere Pro Premiere Pro is a software which we'll be using right now, and it is a popular software that will be used Yeah, it is a popular software that is used even by cinematic professionals, and most of the videos that you'll see are made on Adobe Premiere Pro. There are other softwares also, like there's Final Cut Pro by Apple for Mac users, but Premiere Pro is available on all platforms. I have given you the link, which is a trial version of the software, but it's not necessary that you need that software right now. I mean, I'll be sharing my screen, so you'll be able to see the software and understand. You'll be able to understand what is what. Okay, so don't worry about the software. You can download it later anytime, and it comes for a price. But if you can get the software from any other means, that's up to you. But yeah, the official website has been posted on the group. You can download it from that. And the tools, doesn't matter if it's Premiere Pro or Final Cut or any other software, the tools will almost be the similar on majority of the softwares. So you just have to be familiar with the basics, so that doesn't matter what kind of software you are using, you will be able to start using it. You know, software shouldn't be the problem. So that is the reason even this is mentioned, like the session is mentioned like basic video editing and not just basics of Adobe Premiere Pro or something like that, because the techniques that have been told here can be like, I want you to be able to use any video editing software and work on that. And I'll just start sharing my screen so that you'll be able to see the software. Okay, just give me a few minutes. And Amit, are you able to see my screen? Yeah, fine. As you can see here, once you open software, like you can, once you have installed it, you'll be able to see on the desktop or on in your menu. So once you have opened the software, you'll see a screen, the basic things like start a new project or open an existing project, something like that. So once you, I'll start a new project just so that you guys will be familiar with it. Okay. And for the sample purpose, I'll be showing this promo, which is a 30-second video. But before that, I'll just show the software, how it will look like once you install. And mine is an old version, 2015 version, but in the latest version, it's almost the same except for a few UI and things like that. So yeah, as you can see, once you open the project, once you open the software, you'll be able to see the software, and in the software, you'll be asked to start a new project, and you'll be asked where you want to save it. Once you browse that and see wherever you want to store the file, you can do that. After doing that, you'll have a basic window like this. Okay, yeah. Hope this is visible. Okay, so this is the source board, which will have all the this is a source board which will have all the controls related to the video, and this is the program board. Like if we this is the timeline that will have the video and audio tracks, whichever we'll be putting in, and the final output which will come out as a video will be appearing in this program thing. So, and this is the project. Sorry guys, I think there was a little issue, but I hope it's visible now. Okay, just somebody type in the comments if I am audible now. Fine, perfect. Okay. Thank you. Just a minute. Okay, yeah, I hope my screen is visible now.
Yes.
Okay, yeah. So as you can see, this is the source board. This is the program board, which where you'll be seeing the final output of your video, whichever you'll be editing here on the timeline panel. And all your files that are related to your project will be appearing here in the project panel, okay? So this is what you'll basically see when you open a new project, okay? And once you open a new project, you'll see in here in the file menu on the top left corner, you'll see a new project. If you want to start a new project, open, save the basic options, and then you'll be able to see the import option where you'll be able to import all the files. So once you click on that, you'll be able to see all the files, like wherever your files are stored on your desktop or your system, you can just go there and select the files that you want to import. Or if you have a folder which has all the files, you can select import folder and they will be imported to your project. Or else you can open the folder and then select a file and then open it so that it will be imported to your project. You can select multiple files also, that won't be an issue. So once you have imported all the files, I'll show you the Ibanez promo that I made for Mitake Around. Now, if I import, it might take a little more time. So I already have a project which I made earlier. So I'll be showing this as an example to make you understand. Okay. So here, as you can see, under the project file, I'll just expand this. Okay. So once you open the project file, you'll be able to see all the clips and the images on the audio tracks, everything that I have imported for this project under this project file. Okay. And I have now, let me select any particular file here and then just drop it here. Okay. So this is a text file that I'm having. Okay. So when I, as you can see, this is a KE word in Mitake Around that I just dragged and dropped it on the timeline panel. And after I dropped it, as you can see here on the program panel, you'll be able to see the video where the text file has been imported, and you'll be able to see that. Okay. And whatever files you have imported, you can just drag and drop them on the timeline panel so that you can start working on your project. So that is the first basic step. I mean, initially I was confused about importing files also, but slowly when you do that, you'll be able to do it easily. And the other option is you can open your desktop and then see wherever your files are and drag them directly and import it here. So that, yeah, you can drag them and directly import it on the timeline panel. It will be copied also on the project panel. So you have to make sure that the file is, you have to make sure that the file is is in the particular format. Like I have to tell you the format which Premiere Pro accepts. So most of the video files like MP4 or a .3GP videos will be accepted by Premiere Pro, and it will accept image files which are JPEG files or PNG files or most of the image files, and it will accept audio files which is .wav or .mp3 or there are a few more audio files. So most of them are accepted. In case they are not accepted, then you can search for audio or file converter online. You'll find many file converter softwares. You can convert your file type and add it on your after converting it, you can add it on to your timeline so that it will be accessible. Okay, so here you can see the timeline panel. Okay, in the timeline panel you can see a few pink bars and a few green bars, blue bars. Okay, what you need to what you need to do is just a minute. So yeah, just a minute. Yeah, so sorry, there was a small technical issue. Fine. So yeah, once you drop the videos, all the files will be available on the timeline panel, and then the file types. Okay, here you can see the video tracks and the audio tracks. Okay, all the video tracks are mentioned as V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, etc. So you can add n number of video tracks and n number of audio tracks, and they will be piling up one by one as you add them. Okay, and in the video panel, you can add both the video files and also image files. Okay, and in audio files, you can add only audio files, which can be any recording or any background music or the voice of any other person. Okay, and before we have seen that when I started a new project, it was completely empty, a blank screen, as somebody has mentioned in the chat too. Okay, now the easiest way to have a resolution you have to fix the resolution before you start the project. But instead of doing that, a small hack is try to have the video file or the image file which is in the required resolution size of your output video. Like if you want to have the have a YouTube video which is generally 1280x720p, you can add a video or an image which is of the size 1280x720. Okay, and once you add that, here you'll be seeing on the program panel, you'll be seeing the video of the same size. Okay, now currently this is the video that I made for Instagram promotion. So hence the video is in a square 1:1 ratio. So I had made a small image file which is of 1:1 ratio, so that I can get that resolution. You can later change the resolution size also, but this is the most easiest way to do. Okay, and once you do that, it will be difficult to change the resolution. So make sure you fix on a certain resolution before you even start the project. Okay, and as you drag a video an image file onto the video tracks, you'll be able to see that it is of certain length. Like by default, it will be of 5 seconds length, but you can drag it on the edges and extend it as much as you want. Like you can extend it throughout the video. Like for example, there is this. I'll just expand this. Yeah. So there is this logo file which is on the top right corner of the output video. Okay, and this is stretched throughout the video because the logo needs to be on the whole video, right? So I can decrease the length or increase the length and have the image throughout the video. Okay, and so the image file doesn't matter what kind of image it is, but if it's an acceptable format, it can be sent throughout the video. Okay, and but the video file can't be done in the same way. Okay, if you let me search for a video clip here. Okay, this is an audio file, fine. So video and audio file also, they can't be stretched throughout throughout the video, right? Because their video will be of specific length and they can be only stretched through that length. If you want, you can decrease it, but you can't increase it beyond its limit. Like if a certain video is of the 10 seconds, like this video, for example, is of how many? 7 seconds. So it can't be stretched beyond 7 seconds because the video it can't be stretched beyond 7 seconds because it has only that amount of length. So images can be of images can be put on throughout the length, but the audio needs to be put only to a certain length, which the audio file is, and video needs to be put only to a certain length to which the video file is. And we'll start. Okay, and the video panel, like V1, V2, V3, V4, they keep adding. Okay, so if you have a certain the primary video, like which is the top bottom most video layer, is the one which is at the lower most part, and above that, if you add the new layer will be found, which is above that layer, and V3 will be above V2 and V4 will be above V3, so on. So for example, here logo is on the topmost layer, which is V5, yeah, because logo can't be below the video, right? So logo needs to be above, so that is placed on the topmost layer, and the main video which is our main clip in this whole video will be put at the bottommost layer, so that it can be below the logo file. And similarly, if you want to add more images on the Zoom call, this video was recorded on a Zoom call. So if you want to put a video above video, then you have to keep adding the video tracks. And similarly for the audio tracks, if you have a basic video, like in this video, this guest was speaking. So the A1 track is the blue, dark blue track that you see is entirely his interview. And the A2 track is the background music that I have put, which will come above the audio file. So yeah, you have to keep the order accordingly so that everything can be seen perfectly. If the order is jumbled, then people won't be able to watch what the below layers which are there. Okay, and while editing, if you want to disable a certain file, or like here there is a logo file, and if I want to disable it for a certain time so that I can see the below layers, you can click the eye icon here so that I can see the what is at the bottommost layer. Okay, and similarly there is this M icon, which is the mute track, and if I want to mute a certain track, I can disable the track temporarily so that I can check how the other audio sounds. Okay, and what else? Yeah, and this is these are the toolboxes that you can see right here in between. Most of the tools aren't really necessary because I personally haven't used a lot of them, but you can explore them. But the basic tools that are necessary is the selection tool, which is to select all the the basic tools. To select a certain clip, you have to select the selection tool and then access it. And if you want to cut a certain clip, then you have to use the razor tool. Okay, so for example, this logo file is throughout the video. So if I cut it on here to here, let's say, and if I want to delete a certain part of the video, I can cut it and then delete the video so that that particular part is missing from the entire video. Like as you can see here, the logo won't be visible. Sorry, you have to enable the video. Here, the logo won't be visible, but here the logo will be visible. So you just have to make sure that whichever part you have to select, you can choose it and delete that certain part. Okay, and this bar is to zoom in and zoom out the tracks. If you zoom in a particular track, you'll be able to see the time length. Like if you are not able to see accurately what time length it is, then you can select this zoom bar, and you can zoom in or zoom out to see exactly what is there. And it is currently in time format. If you want to change it to frames format, you can do that also, which you can do in the starting of the project or even during this. Okay, and and you always have the Control Z option in every software, and just in case you mess up something, you can press Control Z and it'll go back to where it was in the starting, so that you don't have to panic about doing something wrong. And in the program file for the video to play, you can see the basic video options, which is play or go forward or go backward. You need not really use this go forward button, since you can select the option like here. If you want to play, you can scrub the seek bar around, and you can play at that particular portion. And there is no limit for the length of the video that should be made. You can make the video as long as you want. As you keep adding, the time keeps adding up. So you need not worry about that. If you want to make even a 3-hour movie or a 5-hour movie, you can keep adding that. But the number of elements that will be there will be complex, and you have to make sure that you name them accordingly so that they are easily visible and identifiable. Okay. So if you select a particular clip or a particular video or an audio, you'll be seeing this effect controls option, which on the left side you'll be able to see the effect controls option, and here you'll be able to manage the properties of the file. Like if it's a image file, you'll be able to see how it can be scaled or positioned. Like again, I take the example of the logo since it's the easiest to explain. Okay, on the top left corner of my video, you'll be able to see the logo. Okay, now I have selected the logo file, and I'll zoom in the video. Okay, so here on the left side, you can see the logo file. Now, if I scale the video. Sorry, if I scale the file, you can see that the logo file will scale up. Okay, and if I want to decrease it, I can do that also. You can go 1000 also, that doesn't matter, but it won't be looking nice. But yeah, by default, it will be at 100 scale, and you can decrease it accordingly as per the requirement. And you can position the logo file accordingly. Now, since we needed it at the top left corner, we have put it there. But if you want to put the logo somewhere on the right or somewhere in the between or middle of the screen, you can do the same. But you have to make sure that the video which is below that logo should be visible as well. So because you can't put only the logo and make the main video not visible. Okay, and the other thing is uniform scale. Now as you can see, you hope probably you would have understood already. So if I want to just stretch the height of the logo, then I can do that. And if you want to keep the width as such, I can put the same. But people won't usually do that because that will damage the resolution of the image or the video. So unless, like, if you are using a solid background, like where resolution won't be a problem, it's recommended to use uniform scale, or else you can unclick it and scale the height and width accordingly. And rotation option is also there, which will rotate the logo to a certain angle. You just have to set the rotation, like if 90 degrees or 97 degrees or 180 degrees. So once you set the rotation, it will change. Okay. And opacity. Opacity, by default, it's 100, which will show the complete logo. If you want to decrease the opacity, you can decrease it by clicking on the logo. As you can see, the logo is not visible since it's just a 4%. But if you want more than 4 or somewhere between that, you can set the time accordingly so that, sorry, set the percentage accordingly so that it looks properly as whatever you want to. Like some people keep only the text in between somewhere on the video with minimum opacity. So you can do that. And the blending, like suppose if I have, I'll do this for a video clip so that you'll understand it better. Okay, see, even if I click the video file, which is the sky blue bar that you see, even if I click that, you'll find the same options in effect controls. Okay, the same position, scale and opacity, etc. Now under opacity, if you can see, if you are a designer, then you would know what are the blending options. It's basically like if you have a layer below another layer, then you can choose what kind of blending you need. Like if you click multiply, now this video doesn't have any video below that because this is the bottommost layer. Now if I click a logo file and make it like dark, as you can see, the logo has disappeared somewhat. So that blends accordingly according to the background that it has. So you can do it as required, as your video requires. And even if you click on a certain file or an image or video or audio, right click on the file, you'll see a ton of options for cutting the file or copying the file, or many more options here. So one major option is enable, like similar to how here you had the I option to enable the video track entirely. Instead of enabling the entire track, if you want to disable or enable a particular clip in the whole video, then you can click on this enable, uncheck this enable thing, so that that particular file won't appear in the final video. Okay. And the other thing is I'll click a video file. Okay, this is a video file, right? Yeah. So on this video file, on this zoom 1.mp4, that is a video file which we have of the interview. If I click on the speed duration, you'll be able to see the speed or duration of the particular file. Like if you want to speed up the video, you can speed it up. You have to increase the percentage, or if you want to slow down the video, you have to decrease the percentage. Now the video will lag. Just mute the audio. So as you can see, it's slower than what it originally was. So if the speed percentage is decreased, then the video slows down. And if you double it up or increase it more than 100, then it speeds up. So you just have to make sure to select that. Select whichever you need. Like if you want to speed up the video, you can. And the other thing is the reverse speed. Like some people make their videos in reverse formats, like as if they are instead of falling down, they are coming up. So if you want to do that, you can make a video of a person falling down, and then you can use this reverse speed option so that the video will look like they are going up instead of falling down. So that is how they do that video. And the other thing is you can set a certain duration. Like let us say this particular clip is for 16 seconds, and if you want to speed it up or slow it down to a particular time, you can select that. Like let's say if I want just 5 seconds, then I can set it to 5 seconds, so that the video will be speeded up and it will be appearing only for 5 seconds. And if I want it for, let's say, 50 seconds, then the video will be slowed down, but it will be there for, like, it will be distributed for 50 seconds. Like if you have no idea like how much length the video will go after speeding up or slowing it down, then you can set a particular duration so that it will match according to your video length. And even that is the same for audio. Usually people don't do that, like speeding the audio or slowing the audio, because they want the exact music or the voice that is needed. But still, if you have a certain sound that you want to speed up, then you can speed up the audio or slow down the audio in a similar way. And you can also reverse it, but it's not really a useful option. Okay. And the other thing, I almost forgot to say this, when you insert particular video file, then it will be by default having two components. One is the video file and other is the audio file, to make sure, yeah, and both of them will be linked. Okay, if you want to unlink them, you have to click the unlink option. Now currently they are both linked and they have the same audio track and the same video track. Okay, now let's say if you want to unlink them, you can right click that file and then now see, I want to click only this sky blue bar, which is the video file, but even the audio file will be selected because both of them are linked together. I can't do the operation on a single file. I have to right click on them and click unlink so that both of them are visible. I can perform the operation on both of them separately. Like if I say, if I want to cut a certain portion of the video, but not the audio, I can't do that because both of them are linked and both of them will be deleted simultaneously, though I have selected only the video file. But if I unlink them, I can select only the video file and then cut it and then delete it. So yeah, you have to make sure, and it's not necessary that you have to link only a certain video and a certain audio file. You can click any video file and any audio file and then link them up together, which is there's no rule that you have to link only the audio which is associated with the video. Okay, and yeah, even with the image, like if you have 4 or 5 images and you want them all to have a certain effect at the same time, then you can link them so that all the 4 or 5 images or 4 or 5 videos can have the same effect. Like if, let's say if I want to decrease like the speed of the video file or the audio file at the same level, then I have to link all of them together so that they can have a certain effect. I don't have to do it multiple times and I can do it in a single time. Okay, and of course there will be auto save that will be popping up as you just saw. In case you forget to save your project or if your laptop has crashed at some point, your laptop will be storing your auto saved files at the same area where you have browsed and saved this particular file. There will be an auto save file option, file which is a copy of this same file, just so that you don't miss out and start from scratch. Okay, and yeah, audio clip mixer is another option. I haven't personally used it because it's mostly for professionals who are working at the video aspect, sorry, at the audio aspect. Like if there is any musician who wants his music to be heard perfectly, then he can do that. But I personally, though I have made videos like for so many years, I haven't used audio so much because most of the things are covered for me in the like by default itself. So I haven't really done much with the audio, but if you are enthusiastic about audio, you can do it here. Or more recommended option is there are other softwares related to audio. You can to edit your audio, like Audacity. So you can learn that software and do it separately. And yeah, effect controls. Yeah, once you click on this, you'll be seeing the effect controls. Okay, there is another option called keyframe. That is a bit complex, but I'll try to explain my best. So let us say if you have a certain logo. Now if I decrease the size, like scale it down to here, I have decreased to 20%, but throughout the video it is for 20% only. Let us say at the start of the video I want it for 100%, and by the end of the video I want it for 20%. like I want it to be decreasing from 100 to 20. How do I do that? So I can click on this video, and then here you can see my logo is still at 20%. I'll click and select 50. So I've selected 50, and then here you can see the option called toggle animation, which is a small clock. Okay, once you click on that, you will get a small icon here, which is called a keyframe. Okay, it means that there is a keyframe there, and on that particular frame, like not for even 1 second, it's only for that particular frame. And then let us say at the end of the video, I want the logo size to decrease to 20%. Okay. Now I can select. Okay. By default, you will see the keyframe is gray, but if I click on it, it will become blue color. It means that a new keyframe has been inserted there. And after clicking that, I can, you still see that the clock is still selected. And if I click on the percentage, then I'm 20%, you'll see the logo has been increased to 20% size. Now here, as you see, at the start it's 50%, but slowly when I go through the video, the logo size will decrease gradually, like from 50 to 20%, it is decreasing gradually. So that way you can put a keyframe on a particular frame, or 1 second. 1 second is wrong context, actually. One frame, wherever you want to decrease it, and it will take the keyframe reference and decrease from start to end. Okay, and that is the same with even position or rotation, or even if you want to scale it like not uniformly, and you want just a scale of the height to decrease and not the width, you can do the same. Like as you can see, only the height is decreasing of the logo here, but not the width. So just have to add the keyframe of that position or that scale, or even if I click on the position, I'll be able to see a keyframe here, or rotation, if I click on it, I'll be able to see a keyframe here. So just have to add a keyframe on the particular frame where you want to have your size of the video or logo of the video decreasing or increasing. Okay, and that is mostly about basic effects which will be having there. Yeah, the basic effects which will be having there. There is another option on this panel. If you click on the right arrow, sometimes it will appear on this panel, but if not, you can click on the right arrow to see all the menus that are on this particular panel. So here, if I click on effects, I'll be able to see different effects. Okay, basically there are two types of effects. One is, there are two categories. One is the videos and other is the audios. And in both categories, there are two types of effects. One is effects, like preset effects, and the other is the transition effects. Okay, first I'll talk about transition effects. Transition, as the name already explains, that effect can be applied only on a particular transition of the video, that is the start or end of the video. It can't be applied at the middle of the video. I'll just show you an example. Okay, audio transitions. Okay, by default you'll be having some effects, but if you want more, you can download from Premiere Pro website, I think, or else there are so many creators online who post different kinds of effects that they have built by themselves. You can download them and install on your software, but by default you'll be having these three a few effects, and under audio you'll be having only these three transitions, for example. Okay, on the top, bottom right corner, if you can see. Okay, and if I take, there's an option called exponential fade, as the name explains, it's exponential fade. So let us say the music or the video is just going da-da-da-da-da, and then slowly you want to decrease it, like slowly, and by the end of the video, so that you don't have a sudden stop in the video. Then you can drag and drop this exponential fade at the end of the video so that you'll have that exponential effect, like slowly the voice will decrease, that effect. Okay, and the same with constant power. Let us say here I have already applied a constant power effect. Okay, let us say there are two different audios which are of different audio levels, and then I want to join them. Both of these are the same audio. Like you can see this is one file and this is another file, but both of them are the same music. Okay, but the audio level of both of them are different. Like here the volume level is something around 100, and the first one, since the dialogues are already running, this is around 60 or 50%. Okay, if I want to combine two different tracks with the different audio levels, I can put a constant power so that they'll have almost the same, like a smooth transition, as if the audio levels are almost the same. Okay, that is for constant power. And constant gain is usually for, let us say, if you are mixing completely two different audios. Like let us say this is the audio track of the person who is speaking, and this green bar is the music of the video, the background music of the video, and I want both of them to have both of them are completely different audio files, but the transition, I want them to be as smooth as possible. Then I can use constant gain so that it won't feel like they are both different audios. It will feel as if they are both same audio. Okay, that is with the transition, audio transitions and audio effects. As I said, again, I haven't used audio much, but the basic ones are denoiser or dehummer. Okay, yeah, denoiser and dehummer. Like if there's a lot of noise in the background and you want to decrease the noise, you can drag this denoiser and apply it on the video file so that if there is any noise, like to a certain level, it will be decreased as much as possible. Okay, and here you have the pan option on the top left corner. That is basically, if you put a earphone, you'll be able to hear it properly, like on the left side how much volume you can hear, and on the right side how much volume you can hear. You can adjust it accordingly by adjusting this pan option. Okay, and that is both the dehummer and denoiser are almost for me, they sound the same, but for an audio expert they might sound different. And there is another option called high pass and low pass. Yeah, so if I want a particular background noise to be heard more, or if I want a particular foreground voice to be heard more, then I'll use low pass or high pass. I'll apply that to the audio file so that I'll be able to hear the background noise more or the foreground noise more. Okay, and there is also the mute option. Like here, since it's a small video, I won't necessarily need it, but if I have, like for cinematic film industry people, they have like 3-hour film, and somewhere they want to mute a certain file, then they can just use this mute option so that that particular clip, like let us say this audio file which I have selected here right now, I want only this to be mute in the entire video, then I can put the mute effect so that only that mute is there. Or else you can always have this mute track option or disable option. Enable disable option so that that particular thing won't be available. But some people use that so that it's more easy when you have more files to use that filter. And for each effect that you will be applying, under the effect controls, you'll be able to see how you can control it. Like if I want to have more volume, like here I have increased like volume. So if I want to have more volume, I can scrub it and increase it accordingly. And yeah, that can be done in the effect controls. Like whatever effect, doesn't matter audio or video, if you are applying an effect, that can be seen in the effect controls panel so that you can change them accordingly as you wish. Okay. And yeah, as you can see here, I applied a low pass filter and it asks for a certain frequency. Now I am not really sure which frequency, but you can play, like you can play the video multiple times and check for different frequencies what audio is suiting your purpose perfectly, and decrease it or increase it accordingly. Okay. Mostly these are the things that I use in audio, which is noise reduction and enhancing a particular audio, and remaining all I haven't really used them because I haven't done much in audio. Okay, when now I come to the video, there are so many effects and so many transitions that I'll see, and first I'll go to the transitions option. So similar to how the audio transitions, you can to make a smooth transition between different audio files, you can also have a video effect so that there are different video files can be transitioned smoothly. There are different options like dissolve, which is mostly used. There is this thing called cross dissolve, which is an effect. Like if I put it on the between two videos, then I'll be able to see the cross dissolve option. Since both of them are the same videos, you won't be able to see that effect. But if they are different videos, you'll be able to see how they are. Yeah, as you can see, edited dissolve, it adds a little light to the video, and you'll be able to see the transition in that particular moment. Now, if I delete that additive dissolve, you won't be able to see that. Okay, so it won't appear in the entire video, but it will be appearing only when two videos are combined, like at the combination of two videos. And there are different options like dip to black or dip to white, completely white screen or completely black screen between two videos. You can do that. And you can, it's really hard to mention all of those effects. They are mostly something for you to play around, like try to apply each effect or transition between two videos so that you'll be able to see each effect and try it yourself. Okay, because that is how I did. Like I have, this is the basic step to add them and do them. It's like a trial and error. Okay, and option called slide. Like if I have two videos and I want that will also be there. So basically so many effects, like these are just a few of them, but on online if you go, you'll get much more. Okay, and here you'll have vibe, which most of them, if you have used PowerPoint, you'll have these animations while doing PowerPoint between different slides. So this is almost the same thing, but much more options are available than that PowerPoint, obviously. And that is in video transitions. Under video effects, a particular effect can be taken and it can be applied to the entire clip or the entire video. Okay, now let us say this particular video has, as you can see, it has a certain quality. Okay, now let us say if I want to blur the video, I can choose the blur option and then apply it here. Okay, and I can go to the effect controls. Here the blurriness is set to 0 by default. If I increase it to 50 minutes, you'll see the entire video has been burned. Now, this is not just happening at the end of the videos, but it is happening to the entire videos. Now, if you want, you can decrease the size of the blurriness or increase the size. But I'll show you how to do that also. That is a bit complicated. If you want to blur a certain portion, I'll show you how to do that. But yeah, for any effect, it's the same thing. You just have to drag the effect and drop it on the clip so that the effect can be seen. You can, in the similar way, you can just see that effect and see whichever works for you. There are color correction, yeah. So these are the basic, the most used video effects that are there. If I want to increase the brightness of a certain video, I can drag this and put this here so that I can, here as you see, by default it is zero, but I increased to 50, the brightness increased. In the same way, contrast also, if you want, I can increase. You can look them around and do that. There are so many noise so as you see, there is a texture on the video because it is a noise texture, and if I increase it, the noise increases. For some videos it may look nice, but for most of the videos it's not really a nice option. So yeah, in a similar way, there are so many textures, effects, and there is even black and white somewhere. So here is this black and white. I can just select black and white and drop it here. So the entire video is black and white. And if you know a certain effect, the name of the certain effect, then you can search here as I just did, and you can you'll get that option below, and you can drag it and drop it there. So just initially it may be difficult, but as the more videos you make, the more easy it would be for you. Like, instead of going through the folder and selecting each effect, it will be easier for you to just type a certain effect and drop it there. But again, to get familiar with all those effects, it will take so much time. Like, I haven't used a lot of effects because most of them, most of the videos will require the basic video effects or video transitions. But if you want to try something extraordinary, then you can definitely look at all these different effects that are available in Premiere by default, or you can download from internet for more. And there is another option called presets in the same effects panel. Presets are basically the filters, like how you see in your Instagram app or in your any photo editing or video editing apps, how you see different filters. That is exactly what presets are. Now, as you can see here, you'll see so many presets which will give so many color to your video. Now, when you record a video on phone or camera, it may not look so appealing, and like it may look like a normal video that you are recording on a phone somewhere. But how to make that more professional and cinematic? Then that is the key, is to use presets, because if you use presets, that will give you that tone that you require in the film. I think I've already used some preset here, but I'll use something else. Okay, and you can see the preview also on the side, as you can see, so that you get an idea of which preset you'll be requiring the most. Okay, now I use this preset called CinemaSpace 100. It gave a yellowish golden tone to the whole clip, and also you can see that only to that particular clip the effect has been applied, the preset has been applied, but not the entire video. Okay, and only for that particular clip I am able to apply that effect. If I want to apply for multiple clips, I can also do that by adding them separately, or there is another option called nesting, which I'll be nesting or adjustment layer, which I'll be explaining just in a while. But yeah, there are so many effects that you can use. You can just look at them the same way you look at filters and try them. Okay, and yeah, those are the light effect presets, and the other thing is like, let us say you want to have a certain effect in your pick. A mosaic means like similar to noise. Like if you want the video to have some noise texture on your clip, then you can use mosaic, or there is some more option, or yeah. So basically those, all of them are, the process is the same. You just have to drag that particular effect and use it on your clip, so that you get an idea that how that clip looks, and if it looks nice, then you can use it, or you can browse for the other ones. And make sure, like, it's not necessary, but make sure you press Ctrl Z. Like if you don't require a particular preset, undo it, so that you don't have so many files stored, or you can delete it, of course, but undoing what you have already applied and don't require, it's much better option. Like I have applied different filters here, presets here, but I don't require all of them. So I can just go to effect controls and click this effects option. It will turn on or turn off the effect. Okay, and of course you cannot remove it as such. Like you can undo it, or else you can click, go to effect controls and turn it on or turn it off. And under each effect, you'll be having different options. Like for brightness, you'll be having the brightness option. For noise, you'll be having the noise percentage option. So each effect will have a different set of options. You just have to see for each effect. Like it's not like there's a particular set of options that will be available for all the effects. Each effect has a different set of options, and you'll be seeing them under your effect controls panel. Okay, and a media browser or libraries is the same thing. Like if you have a certain file online or on your local computer, you'll be able to download them or import them and have it in your project. Okay, and history will show you. Not necessarily, but if you are making a very big file and you're not sure what you have applied, then you can click the history option, so that you can see what all files have, what all effects have been done, or whatever you did so far in the video will be shown in the history option, so that you get an idea. Okay, I did this particular thing in this particular after this particular sequence. Okay, and yeah, that's mostly about effects. You have to try them yourself to see how they look like. And there is another option called nesting. Okay, here, yeah, you can see a green color bar here in the video layers, right? So this is a light green bar. This is a nested sequence. What a nested sequence will do is combine two or three files together and put them in a single file. Now let us say, now when I applied an effect, it is appearing only on one clip. Like it is not appearing on another clip. I've selected just one clip here, which is appearing in white. It's a, the effect is coming on only one effect, one clip. But if I want to have that effect on multiple clips, then I have to press shift and then select multiple files. Sorry, yeah, select those multiple files and then right click on it and click nest. Where is nest? Yeah, and then it will show nest. You can select a name, Usually I'm putting it as nested sequence four, but it's recommended to have a name so that you can recognize whenever you make a new nested sequence. Okay. Now here, I have selected three clips and all three of them are stored in one nested sequence. Okay. Now when I double click on this nested sequence, a new window will be opened up, which will have all the three files which I have nested, and you can arrange them like if you want to decrease it or increase it, or you can do it inside the nested sequence. But the purpose of nested sequence is that, let us say if I want to, apply black and white filter on this. Now I'll be seeing the black and white filter on all the clips that I've nested under one sequence. Okay. So that is one of the advantage of nested sequence. And in the same way, if you have, let us say if you have like multiple interviews to make, like if you have a certain template that you have, like you have made a video, which is a podcast of somebody, want to make the same podcast like from scratch again, then you can save the same file and nest all the files in one particular nested sequence, so that you can use it multiple times. Like all you need to do is you can go inside the nested sequence, replace these files that you are seeing here, and you can make a new video with the same template that you're using before. So that is a time saving thing. There are many more things that you can do with nested. Okay, yeah. When I decrease the nested sequence, I'll be able to see only the length which have increased. Or if I try to increase it like beyond what it's already there, it won't happen because nested sequence only has, like, I'm trying to increase it here, but I'm not able to increase because inside the nested sequence only these many videos are there. And as I said in the starting, how many ever videos are there, only that length can be there on screen. It can't be increased beyond what it's already there. If you want to decrease it, you can obviously decrease it. And whatever options you apply or do on this particular video, that will reflect on a nested sequence also, on the overall video also. And every operation that you do for images or videos or audios that I've said earlier, you can also do that with nested sequence. Like if I click on it, you can see the effect controls for each thing, and if I right click on it, you'll be able to see all the options which were already there for video also. Okay. And two more things that you can do in after right clicking is audio gain. So audio gain, once you click on that, this is one thing which I mostly use in the audio is if I want to decrease the volume level, you can obviously use the effect, audio effect, which I have shown earlier, or else you can set the audio gain. Like let us say the audio is going in a certain level and I want the volume to be increased, then I can increase the set gain to much more than what it's already there. Or I can, if the audio is like much louder than what it already is, then I can decrease it. Like I can decrease it to a minus or a plus as much as I want, or I can just click on the number like 20 decibels and do it. Now the audio will be increased, audio level will be increased than what it already is. Or the other option is you'll be having the audio adjust gain by. So it is, instead of setting the particular gain, adjust gain increases the audio than what it already was. What is the difference between both of them? In set gain, you can set the audio level to a certain number, but in adjust gain you can increase, like let us say after 15, now it's currently at 15 decibels. Now if I set adjust gain by, then it will multiply however how much ever you are increasing into the 15 decibels. Okay, so it, that is for adjust gain, but mostly I use set gain so that I can fix the value of how much ever audio I want. And yeah, there is another option called if you are installing a new version, you'll be seeing that there will be an option called tool under this tools options. You'll be seeing a text option also. The text option will enable you to write on screen, like how you write on Photoshop or any other editing software. In the same way, you can click on text tool and write on your video wherever you want the text file to be there. But mine is an older version, so what 2015 version. So what I have to do is on the topmost menu, I have to go to title and click new title, and I can click default still, which is the text file basically. So once I click on the text file, I'll be able to see whichever text I want. I can select that. Just a minute. Yeah, so as you can see, it asks for the width and the height, so it is a little complex. Typing just the text is a little complex in the older version, but in the newer version I don't have it right now. But yeah, once you click on text, you can just start typing on the screen. It is easy. Once you see that option yourself, you'll be much familiar with that. Okay, and what else? Yeah, that is mostly it. So I'll show you how to export it and render it also. But yeah, these are mostly it. You can export the files, and all of your files will be stored in project, and you can drag them and put them on the timeline layer, and you can set the length of the video or the audio, whichever is on the timeline panel, and whatever effect your or whatever operation you do on this timeline panel, which will be shown on the program panel. Like you can see how your output video will look like, and once you click on a particular clip or audio or video, you'll be able to see all the effect controls that are regarding to the particular video or audio. Okay, and yeah, you can adjust the effects accordingly, and whatever effect and effects option is there with the projects option, once you can click whatever effect you want and drag it and apply it on the files or the clip or the audio or video, and whatever effect is there, you can see the effect in the effect controls, and you can adjust the effects accordingly. Okay, and after that, finally you can see your output video however it comes out. And then you just need to add the video or audio file beside or there at the end of the video, like wherever you want the clip to be, so that you'll be able to see the output video file on the main video. Okay, so that should mostly cover the basic video editing. But if there are more things and you'll understand them better once you start using the software, and I'll just tell you a few shortcuts that you can use. Now let us say if you are in the timeline panel and if you want to go to the start or end, select home, you can go to the start of the video, And if you select end, you can go to the end of the video. And if you press space, you can play the video. Okay. And if you press enter, you can, like most of the videos, like after you compile or place them, everything here, they will lag a bit. There will be a little bit of buffer. Okay. So if you press enter, you'll be able to see rendering. So what rendering is, just rendering means processing. So if it processes such that there won't be any lag, as you can see, I rendered a little for 3 seconds or 5 seconds. Sorry. Okay. 1 second maybe. And you can see a green bar over here. The red bar indicates that the video has been not rendered and the rest of the video, but yeah, the green bar indicates that it's rendered. It is just to make sure that you can view the video smoothly. Okay. And this is mostly what video editing is. I'll just show you how to export, like once you have the entire video, how to export it. Okay. So if you go to file and then click export, you'll have the export. Under export, you'll have media option. Once you click that, you'll see the format and then different options regarding to export. Here under output name, you can click on output name and then you'll be able to save the file somewhere. Let us say I want to save the file, and here it will be showing the file type, whichever I'm saving. And the file name, whichever I want to save, I can do that. And before saving, you have to make sure that you select the format. So the basic mostly used format is .mp4, which is here written here as H.264. H.264 is mostly the highest quality that you can get, but again, you can get, under preset, you'll be able to see different options for exporting. Now let us say if you want to export it, now if I scroll here, I can go all the way to YouTube format, Facebook format. Also for each device, there is a different format. So you can select whichever format, like if you are uploading YouTube, then you can select YouTube. But most recommended ones are the topmost, which is the match source, high bitrate, and match source medium bitrate. So match source is like whichever, doesn't matter which device you are playing it on, or doesn't matter which platform you're uploading it on, it will try to adjust accordingly. So match source is the recommended preset that you have to give. And high bitrate is the video will be in much better quality if it's in high bitrate, but if it's in medium bitrate, it will be in a much lower quality, like almost at the bottom most, you will see this estimated file size. Okay. Now in medium bitrate, it is showing 49 MB. Just above this Q option, you will be able to see the estimated file size. So if I click on high bitrate, you can see it's 159 MB. But if I click on medium bitrate, but it's showing almost like not even half, so much more than half of the file size has been decreased. Now, obviously the file size decreases means that the quality of the video will also decrease. So that is the only price you have to pay if you want reduced file size. There are other softwares online where you can decrease the file, online converters where you can decrease the file size. So if you want a particular, like if you have like movies, they have like 3 hours. Now this is just a 30-second clip, but it's showing already 200 MB. Now movies, they have like 3 hours. How do they make it like 4 GB or 1 GB or 700 MB? So that is done with this preset, and then some more softwares that they use to decrease the file size. Okay. And that is mostly it. These are the basic options. Like while you output the video, you can see under the video, you'll be able to see target bitrate and maximum bitrate. Maximum bitrate is the highest bit rate that you can go, but when you, that won't really change much. But if you go to target bit rate and change the level, you'll see a decrease in file size. So that is also, quality decreases when you decrease target bit rate, but again the file size will also decrease. Now most of the videos we won't have much effect, but again if you want to have lesser file size, you can do that. And that is why it is recommended that you shoot your videos. Like, you can't just think that you can shoot your videos on anything and then start editing them to make them better. You have to shoot, like cinema people, they shoot in 4K or 8K so that it gives maximum quality. Okay. And yeah, so as you decrease the bitrate, the quality will decrease, but the file size will also decrease. Okay. And once here, you have to make sure that you click both export video and export audio option. If you don't click that, you'll get only the video file or the audio file. So you have to make sure that doesn't happen. And you'll get a summary of all the things, like wherever it is saved and whatever resolution it has, etc. Now this is one by one, 1:1 ratio video size, as I said, and it has the same specifications. Okay. And you can select the audio, like you might have heard in while downloading audio files, you would have seen bit rates like 128, 32, 64. So that will also decrease the quality a bit. As you can see, 1 MB is decreased. So you can change the audio bit rate also, but that doesn't really affect much here, since the major part of the file size is due to the video. Okay. And yeah, that is mostly it. And once you export the file, you'll be able to see the file in your, wherever you have saved it. And you can play your video, and if you, yeah, it will play in the same ratio that you have mentioned at the start of the video. So yeah, that should mostly cover it. And there is like much more things that you can do in video editing, but most of them don't really aren't really useful for most of us right now, because they are much more professional. But what you can do is, you can, there are so many video editing channels, where are so many YouTubers who are doing that. You can follow them and try to make your own videos, so that you will be able to create different kinds of videos. There is no particular rule to say that this is how you have to make videos. It is just based on your creativity that you can make as many videos as you can. But yeah, this is the basic, these are the basic effects. Like, doesn't matter what kind of video you want to make, this is the whole thing that you will be requiring. So I tried to cover most of it, but again, if you have any doubts, I can definitely answer, not just now, even later. Like, my details are given in the group. So if you have any doubts, you can definitely contact me so that I can answer you better. And what else? Amit, is there anything you want to say? Yeah, there will be more. Thank you for adding this podcast in the first place. And there will be more, sorry, not podcast, sorry, workshop in the first place. And there will be more, masterclasses that will be happening soon. And make sure you attend them, because most of them are related to different fields that you might not be really an expert in. So you will get to learn a lot of them. So yeah, that is mostly it. If you want to ask any doubts, you can. I think there are so many people on the chat saying a lot of things. Okay, Amit, is there anything you want to say before?
No, I think it's pretty good, and it was pretty great for 1.5 hours. And I think most of the questions we have listed down on our chat, and we'll take it on the group itself. So yeah, thank you so much, Rohit. Once again, I think we are good to end if you are okay to, you know, shut it down.
Yeah, just everybody were asking like if they have any things, like if they want to contact me, the details are given on the group. You can definitely contact me and ask me if you have any doubts. Like many of them are really like technical. It will take much more time to explain right here. So if you contact me, I'll be able to explain you better. And yeah, make sure you fill the feedback form so that I can improve it in a better way. And if you want advanced, this is a basic video editing course. If you want an advanced session, please mention in the form so that we'll be able to arrange that. So yeah, that should mostly do from my side. Amit, if you want to say anything else, you can.
No, perfect, good to go.
Okay then, thank you so much. People, see you.
Bye-bye, take care, thank you. Thank you, Rohit.
In the messages, I got a lot of messages seeing in that. Bye. Yeah, I know some of you are still online. I was just looking at your questions so that fine. Okay, I'll try to answer them in that. Bye bye.